Hi, this is Gary with MACMOST.com. Today, let's take a look at editing audio in GarageBand. MACMOST is brought to you thanks to a great group of more than 900 supporters. Go to MACMOST.com/Patreon. There, you can read more about the Patreon campaign, join us, and get exclusive content and course discounts. So GarageBand is a great free app from Apple that you could use to make music. You can record an instrument, you can build your own music tracks, loop things, add drums, and all of that. But you could also use it just to edit audio. So if you have an audio file and you need to trim it or you need to merge two audio files or maybe mix two different audio files together, you can easily do that in GarageBand as well. So starting off here in GarageBand, when you create a new empty project, it's going to ask you to put a track in there. And since we're going to be working with plain regular audio, we want to use this track here with the microphone. That's a regular audio track. So we'll create this new document here, and we could see here is that track that was created. And we could see some settings down below. We can see a library here on the left. We can close that to give ourselves a little more space here. And various other things. In order to work with audio in GarageBand, you don't open the audio file. GarageBand has to work with the GarageBand project. So you want to create one of these projects, then bring the audio in. Let's prepare a little bit first. First thing we want to do is turn off the metronome here and the count in. We don't need those for this kind of project. And also click here and change from using beats to using time, which is more applicable when just editing audio files. Now to bring in the audio, all we need to do is drag and drop. So behind this GarageBand window, I've got a Finder window with some audio files. And I can take one of those and drag it in and put it right here at the beginning of this first sound track. And this is just some spoken audio.
Hi, this is Gary, and this is my show all about wombats.
So we can play to hear any portion of it. We can move the playback head anywhere we want and continue playing.
Later on, I'm going to interview a wombat.
So now if we want to actually trim some off the end, like let's say we just want to keep this section here and kind of trim it at this point, we can do it one of a couple ways. One way is we can move the cursor to the end of the track. And when you do, notice there are two portions there, the upper portion and the lower portion. The upper portion deals with loops, which is something you would use if you're making music. In this case, we just want to trim this plain audio. So we want to use the lower portion here, which is the end of the track. And we can click and drag that in to cut off everything after that. You can easily expand it back again or remove it to change it if you want. The audio doesn't go away. Matter of fact, it stays there. And if I were to save this as a GarageBand project, that track would continue to have that extra audio in it. Now, if we were to export this from GarageBand now, we would get this audio and it would stop here, except that it would continue to play lots of silence because the track is actually longer than the 20 seconds here. If we scroll over, we could see that this is the end of the track past the 1 minute mark. So I want to drag that in and place that close to the end of the track, maybe with a little bit of extra silence at the end. So that's now the length of the track, and now I can export this as a new audio file that's trimmed, missing the end there. And in a few minutes, we'll take a look at exactly how to export. But first, let's look at some other things that we can do. What if I wanted to put another audio track, merge two audio tracks together? Well, I can drag and drop a second track. Let's do this one. And I could put it in another track by itself. But in this case, I'm going to put it after the first track, like that. So now I've got this first bit here, and it's been trimmed, then some silence, and then starts this next piece. So I can adjust this as I like to get the pause just right. So I can adjust this, maybe a little less there. And I can also trim this track as well. And you can see here the end of the track has moved because it needed to make space. Let's move that in. So now I've taken two pieces of audio and place them together. And when I export, it's just going to be one audio file with both of these things in it. Now what if we wanted to mix things? So I actually have two sounds playing at the same time. You may have noticed I've got a little song here, and I could drag that in, but instead of into this track, I'm going to drag it down below and add it as a second track. And this is some music. So now when I play, and I'll move the playback head all the way to the beginning, it's going to play both the audio spoken here and the music.
Hi, this is Gary, and this is my show all about.
Now you can include as many tracks as you want, so I could add a third or fourth, for instance. One thing you may want to do is lower the volume of one of these tracks to get the mix just right. So you can see here on the left, I've got volume controls, and we can lower the volume down for the song here so that the audio is predominant and the music is just in the background. And we can test that out.
About wombats, the amazing animal that lives in Australia and some parts of Nebraska.
Now this song is really long here, so we want to trim that as well. So let's bring the end in here and scroll over, bring it so it's right about there. Maybe have the music continue a little bit longer afterwards. And then let's bring the end of the track in, something you're going to be doing a lot. And once you have the end of the track right about there, now we've got some spoken audio, some music in the background set at a good volume. One thing we may want to do is have the music fade out. You can do that by viewing automations. Automations will allow you to change the volume over a period of time. That's why it's automation. It's an automatic change of volume. So if we go to Mix, Show Automation, it's going to show us the automation for each of these, in this case volume. And if you look closely here, there's a yellow line. And if I select this track instead, you can see this yellow line appears here. And this is the volume level, because remember this volume is lower than this. I could click in here to create a point and then another point and then have it change between them. So I could go to about here, click for one point, click here for another point. Then I could click and drag this point down. And now the volume will decrease starting here. So we'll get a fade out with the music.
Brilliant accent.
Now there's also a quick way to do that since fade out is so common. You can go to Mix, Create Volume Fade Out on Main Output. When I do that, I get this master track here. And I can actually hide or show the master track, which allows you to set an automation like this, but that covers all the tracks instead of just this one. So you can see here it does a fade out over several different points here at the end. I don't want to do that here. I've already created my own fade out. So I'll undo and I'll hide the master track. So now that we've done all of that, it's time to export this. We can double check again to make sure the end of the track is here so there won't be a lot of silence there. We've got a good volume level set here. Notice the volume looks smaller there. If I drag this over, the volume level will change depending upon where I'm at because I have that fade out. One thing to keep in mind is you can use this control here to zoom in or out to see more or less of what you're working with, which will help in setting all of this up. And now let's export. So to export, all you need to do is go to Share and then use Export Song to Disk. And here we can select what type of file to use. So AAC is a really good standard to use. You can set it to four different quality levels. You can go to MP3 if that's a requirement for whatever it is you're doing, or use the AIFF or WAV file formats. I'll just stick with AAC. I'll go to the highest quality there. I'll give it a name and I'll set it to this directory that I was using before and export it out. And you can see the progress shown right there by the playback head. Let's hide GarageBand. Now we could see there is the new file there and it's a combination of all three of these.
Hi, this is Gary and this is
And I just want to show you a few more tips. I told you before that you can trim the end of a track by grabbing it like that. You can also move the playback head to a certain point. And then if you go to Edit and you see there's split regions of playhead, which is Command T. So you can do Command T to split this up. So this allows you then move this piece somewhere else if you want, or simply just delete it. So that could sometimes be a faster way to trim things than actually dragging from the end. It's also a really good way to get rid of things at the beginning because I could have selected this one and gotten rid of it. You could also go here to the beginning and trim off the beginning as well and then perhaps move this over to fit. Now maybe while you're working on the spoken audio here, you would maybe want to silence the music so you can mute a track that way. Or alternatively, you can click the headphones here and that solos a track. In other words, all other tracks are muted except the ones with this turned on. Also, one of the things you may want to do is filter. So let's filter these two pieces of audio here. I'm going to shift click to select both of them. Let me go back to the library here and you're going to see filters here in the library because I have a regular audio track selected. I can go to voice and I can change the voice here. What's useful for choosing one of these is to set the cycle to on, and this will give you this little piece here and it'll just keep looping through this. So as I play, this will just loop and then I could try some of these different things. Notice all of these controls here will change as I pick different filters.
Hi, this is Gary and this is my show all about wombats, the amazing animal that lives in Australia and some parts of Nebraska. Hi, this is Gary, and this is my show all about wombats, the amazing animal that lives in Australia and some parts of Nebraska.
Hi, this is Gary, and this is my show
all about wombats, the amazing animal that lives in Australia and
some parts of Nebraska.
I think the narration vocal probably works best for this. And now when I export, it'll have that narration vocal filter applied to this track. So you can see it's fairly simple to actually edit audio in GarageBand. A lot of people are intimidated by GarageBand because there's so much that you can do in it. But if you just want to stick to basic audio tracks, trimming things, putting in maybe two tracks into a mix and changing the volume for one, some simple fade outs and some filters, it's actually fairly simple to use. Hope you found this useful. Thanks for watching.
If you liked this video, click the thumbs up button below to let me know. I publish new tutorials each weekday. Hit the subscribe button so you don't miss out.